In this module, we're going to talk about relative solubilities of salts. That is, you know, with comparing two or more salts, which one is more soluble than the other. And so first, if and only if a salt breaks apart into the two salts break apart into the same number of ions, such as these three, silver iodide, copper one iodide, and calcium sulfate, each of these breaks apart into two ions, then we can just look at the KSPs and compare their solubilities. We can say that the one with the smallest KSP will be the least soluble. The one with the largest KSP will be the most soluble. So here, silver iodide has a KSP of 1.5 times 10 to the minus 16th, and its solubility, remember, that's defined. Remember the solubility, it's how much of the salt will dissolve in a liter of solution, how many moles per liter. And so because this is all one-to-one, the solubility is equal to the, it's basically, it's going to be S squared is equal to KSP, so square root of KSP is going to be S, the solubility. It's just like X is from our ice table. And the same thing for copper 1 iodide, because 1 and 1, the solubility, it's just going to be the square root of KSP. And for calcium sulfate, because they break it apart, it breaks apart into two ions, the solubility is equal to square root of KSP, and so the smaller the KSP, the smaller the square root of KSP, the smaller the solubility. So these, because they all break apart into two ions, the same ion, number of ions as each other, we can just look at the KSPs and say that silver iodide has the smallest KSP, so is the least soluble. Calcium sulfate has the largest KSP, and so is the most soluble. And copper one iodide is right in the middle. But if salts produce different numbers of ions, we have to be careful. We have to actually calculate the solubility. So let's compare copper 2 sulfide, silver sulfide, and bismuth 3 sulfide. So copper 2 sulfide breaks apart into two ions, and so the solubility once more will be the square root of the KSP, which ends up being 9.2 times 10 to the minus 23rd. That's how many moles per liter of copper 2 sulfide will dissolve in a liter of solution, aqueous. Not very much, right? Now, silver 1 sulfide. Now, that breaks apart into, silver sulfide, breaks apart into two silver ions and one sulfide ion. So this is going to be, in our ice table, this would be 2S and this would be S. Of course, this isn't in our KSP. So KSP will be equal to 4S squared times S, which is 4S cubed. Setting that equal to KSP, solving for S, the solubility, we get 3.4 times 10 to the minus 17th. And that's a bigger number than this. So comparing these two, even though silver sulfide has a smaller KSP than copper 2 sulfide, it actually has a greater solubility. More moles per liter of this will dissolve. And then looking at bismuth 3 sulfide, breaks apart into two bismuth 3 ions and three sulfide ions. So the the KSP will be equal to 4s squared times 27s cubed, which is 108s to the fifth. That's equal to KSP, which is 1.1 times 10 to the minus 73rd at 25 Celsius. Solving for S, we get 1 times 10 to the minus 15th. And so that's an even larger number than the other two. So even though bismuth 3 sulfide had by far the smallest KSP, we can see it's the most soluble. So when you're figuring out relative solubilities, you can only say that the one with the smallest KSP is the least soluble and the one with the largest KSP is the most soluble if they break apart into the same number of ions. If they don't, you're going to have to basically calculate the solubilities like we did right here.